Hello friends, this is Nick from NLB Solutions, and today I'm going to show you how to install and configure remote access on Windows Server 2012 R2. We all know that the VPN server is a core solution that is implemented in Windows servers from a long time ago with older versions of the Windows Server, and in our days a lot of corporations and environments need this remote access for their users to perform their day-to-day tasks. So in this video I'm going to install the remote access role on Windows Server 2012 R2, then I'm going to configure the remote access role for VPN only. After we configure this, I'm going to switch to the remote access routing and remote access console, and I'm going to configure all the settings that are needed for my users to be able to connect to my VPN server. After that, I'm going to switch to a Windows 10 client machine, and in there I'm going to configure a VPN connection so we can test out to confirm that my VPN server is working fine. Before we switch to the demo, I just want to provide you some tips and tricks. Depending on the tunneling protocol that you're going to use for your VPN server, you need to take care of and you need to open some ports on your firewalls or on your routers. And as I said, depending on the tunneling protocol, you have several different options, and you can see the ports that are needed. In my case, I'm going to use the BPTP protocol, and it requires port 1723 TCP and the protocol 47, the GRE. And I've seen a lot of issues with the GRE protocol. A lot of internet providers are blocking this pass-through. So if you have any problems with connecting to your VPN server from home, for example, you need to see if your internet provider, your ISP, is blocking this for you. And another tip and trick, in order for you to connect to the VPN server, your administrator needs to provide you with the needed access, the needed permissions to perform a dial-in. So let's start with the demonstration. So first, what we need to do is we need to install the remote access role. So I'm going to log into my Windows Server 2012 R2. I'm going to start by adding this role to my server. And as you all know, you can add and remove roles from the manage into the server manager dashboard. And from here, I'm going to click next, select the server, scroll down a bit, and here you can see the remote access role. And basically this remote access role provides a lot of functionalities like direct access, VPN, a web application proxy, and a lot of other things. So I'm going to select this role and click next. I don't need any features because the role is going to select the features by itself, the needed ones. And here there is a small description of what you can do with the remote access role. There are a lot of things that can be done here. So I'm going to the additional role services that I want to install and I'm going to configure is the first one, which is the Direct Access and VPN RAS. And it's going to ask me if I will allow for additional features to be added, so I'll add the features and press next. And I'm going to click install and wait for the wizard to finish adding the remote access VPN server. Now that the installation has finished successfully, it will say that additional configurations are required, and from here you can launch the Getting Started wizard, or you can close this window, and right here you will see an exclamation mark, and basically it's the same wizard but from a different perspective. So I'm going to select this wizard and we'll wait for it to fully load in. So as you can see, you have three options here. You can deploy both direct access and VPN. You can deploy only direct access or only VPN. For the purpose of this video, I'm going to deploy VPN only, and if you want in the future, I can show you how to deploy the direct access as well. But the direct access is really a cool feature. It's basically a VPN that's automatically and automatically connects your users to your environment, so they don't need to create any additional VPN configurations on their side in order for them to connect. Basically automatically connects the users to your environment. So I'm going to deploy VPN only, and in here you can see that now I can see the routing and remote access console, and from the left side of the screen I can see that there is a down arrow, which is a red arrow, and what it says is I need to perform additional configurations in order for me to power on and start the service. So I'm going to right click here and configure and enable routing and remote access. So another small wizard will appear, and when I click next, I have different options that I can configure. Again, the options are depending on the what you want to implement in your environment. You need to check them one by one and see what fits best for you, but in my case I'm going to deploy only VPN, and that's why I'm going to choose custom configuration. So in the custom configuration I can deploy a specific set of tools that I can install and configure on my routing and remote access server, but I'm going to select the VPN access only for now and click next, and you can see by clicking finish it will say that it will ask me if I want to start the service. So I'm going to start the service now. Okay, and now on the left side you see that the arrow changed to a green up arrow, which is a good sign. It's basically saying that my server is up and running at the moment, and if I go through the different options that I have, I will see different for example the ports that are available for me to use and the different tunneling protocols that I can configure. And the network interfaces, of course, I can see my dedicated external card that is used for the VPN connection, the internal connection, the loopback as well. And from the third option, I can see the remote access clients. Basically, when a client connects to this server, you will see the connection right here, and you can check the status of the connection, you can close the connection, so you will disconnect basically this user from using the server at the moment. And under IPv4 I can see other information for the routing and how it's done, but in order for me to fully configure the server so that when a user tries to connect to this server it can receive an IP address, and if you have a DHCP currently configured on the server, you can use the DHCP to give out addresses, or you can configure a DHCP relay agent, but in my case I don't have a DHCP server here, so I'm going to open the properties, and under IPv4 you can see that the dynamic host protocol is currently selected, but if you want a static address pool to be given to the users, you can add the static pool from here. So that's what I'm going to do now. So I'm going to click add and specify the start and the end IP addresses that I want to give to my client. So for example, I will give a static IP address that is currently in my range, and I'm going to allow only 5 users to be able to connect with VPN. So this is another way for me, you can see number of addresses 5, this is another way for me to restrict the users alongside with permissions, of course. And now that I've configured only 5 addresses, only 5 connections will be available for this server to give out. So I'm going to close that. And basically the configuration of the routing and remote access server is done. The other thing that I mentioned in the presentation is that you need to open, depending on the protocol that the users are going to use, you need to open different ports on your firewall or router to allow the connection to hit the server. So as I'm going to use this in a local environment, I don't need to configure that, but you need to bear that in mind. Now that I'm on my local machine, I'm going to use another user to log into that machine, and that's the account for J. Thompson. Okay. For Jesse Thompson, and she's going to be a user that is going to use VPN connection from home, and I'm going to pause the video until the initial login and initial configuration of her profile is done, so we can keep the video short. Now that the profile loaded successfully, what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click on the internet access icon on the bottom right side and open Network and Sharing Center. And from here I can set up a new connection or network, so I'm going to click that and select set up a dial-up or VPN connection to your workspace. So I'm going to click next, and I'm going to use internet in order for me to connect to my my server. So under the internet address, as I said, I'm going to use a local VPN in order for me to test out and show you how to configure the VPN. But basically, this will work with an internet address in order for you to hit the VPN server. So I'm going to specify my local address, which is 192.168.142.26. And you can name the VPN connection. I'm going to name that Work VPN. And from here you have different options to remember the credentials or allow other people, which is not really secure. So I'm going to just create the VPN connection. And now that I've created the VPN connection, there is a thing that I like to do basically. And that is when I create a VPN connection, in order for the users not to use the default gateway of my environment, I go ahead and deselect an option which is right here under the advanced TCP/IP settings, which is use default gateway on remote network. So I'm going to deselect that, click OK. Okay, so now Jesse is set up to connect to my VPN server. So I'm going to right double click on that. Of course, you can go ahead from here and it will show the VPN work connection that we did, and it will open basically the same window where you can connect to that VPN. So I'm going to specify the account for Jesse Thompson and her password and click OK. So now it's basically saying that it cannot connect to the work VPN, and it's saying that the remote access connection was denied because the username and password combination you provided is not recognized, or the selected authentication protocol is not permitted on the remote server. Actually, the main problem with that is I did not added Jesse to the allowed users to make a VPN connection. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to switch to my domain controller, and I'm going to open Jesse's account and allow her to make a connection on the VPN. Before I switch to my domain controller, I just want to show you a basic troubleshooting step that it's a good idea for you to perform in order to find out what is preventing the users from connecting to your server. So I'm going to open Event Viewer, and when I expand the Windows logs and go under System, I will see that I have warnings, and these warnings, when I click on them, I can see that the account user for James Thompson connected on port VPN does not have remote access privileges. So this is a basic troubleshooting guide that can help you resolve issues with your VPN server. For example, here you will find when a user and an internet provider is blocking the GRE packets 47 from their environment, the PPTP pass-through, they will show here as a warning message, and you will know that this is the problem with the user. Now that I'm on my domain controller, I'm going to open Tools and then Active Directory Users and Computers, and under my NLB Lab domain and my OU NLB Solutions. I have an OU users with JC Thompson's account. So I'm going to right click and open properties of that account. And when I go in the tab dial in, I will see that the first option, the network access permissions, is currently set on control access to the MPC network policy. Basically, I don't have an MPC server, network policy server at the moment to detect and see if my users are compliant. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the allow access for the J. Thompson user and click apply. So now when I go to my Windows server, Windows 10 machine, and click close to that message and try to connect again with her account and the password, I will see that the connection worked and I'm currently connected to the NLB lab environment with a VPN connection. So I can see that I'm currently using the PPTP port, which I want to see. And if I run a CMD and open that and show the IP config settings, I will see that the PPP adapter work VPN currently gave me the IP address of 192.168.142.231, which is the first address that I gave to my VPN users when they connect to my environment. So I can see that and I can confirm that my VPN server is up and running and my users can connect to my corporate environment using that. So this ends up the demonstration of how you can configure, install and configure VPN server in Windows 2012 R2. I hope you like the video. If you like it, press the like button. If you don't like it, press the dislike button and give me a comment what can be improved so I can take this into consideration. Thank you very much for viewing and see you soon.